Hello, Brownsburg High School. Thanks for watching BHS TV. Today is Friday, September 20th. I'm Ashlyn Watts.
And I'm Jordan Winter, and here's what's going on at BHS. BHS TV wants you to share all of your homecoming pictures by posting them to Twitter or Instagram and using the hashtag BBurgHC19. We will post them to the TVs around the hallways and even choose some to be seen right here on the next few episodes of BHS TV. Thanks to everyone who has participated so far. We hope to see more throughout the weekend.
Today is the last day to buy homecoming dance tickets. You can get one at lunch for $10. The dance will take place in the field house tomorrow, Saturday, September 21st at 7 p.m. You must purchase a ticket ahead of time. They will not be sold at the door. Also, you must bring your Brownsburg student ID with you to enter the dance, along with your pre-purchased ticket.
BHS is starting a film club this year. If you have an interest in writing creative stories, working behind the scenes, or learning about how films are edited, come to the call-out meeting on Monday, September 23rd. The meeting will take place after school in Mr. Good's room in the Media Center Lab A. If you have any questions, see Blake Fonin or Leister Perrin.
FCA is having See You at the Pole this Wednesday at 7:05 at the flagpole by door 12. See You at the Pole is a time of prayer over our school and our nation, and it's done by all FCAs across the nation at the same time. Come join us.
Are you still thinking about what to do over spring break 2021? If so, there's still time to sign up for the Costa Rica and Panama trip. The deadline for the $200 early enrollment discount has been extended to the end of September. If you have any questions about the trip or need more information, please either email Mr. Friedman or Mrs. Muller or stop by A2310 or B2326.
Seniors, College Go Week is next week. If you need help with applications, Naviance, or sending test scores, Mrs. Martin will be holding help days all week during lunch. Please see her if you have any questions. Do not wait until the last minute. In honor of College Go Week, Wednesday, September 25th will be College Jersey or Shirt Day, so plan to wear your favorite college jersey or shirt on Wednesday.
This week's student handbook topic is academic integrity. Academic dishonesty occurs when students obtain or assist others in obtaining credit for academic work which is not their own. Cheating is the use of unauthorized materials or receiving unauthorized assistance, acquiring unacknowledgeable materials, information or study aids in any academic exercise. Plagiarism is the representation of the words or ideas of another as one's own in any academic exercise. Appropriate acknowledgement is required when material from another source which is in print form, electronic form, or other medium which is paraphrased or summarized. Students may not knowingly or negligently allow their academic work to be used by other students and presented as another's work.
BHS is starting a new speech team this year and is looking for members who like performing or speaking in front of others. The call-out meeting will be next Thursday, September 26th, after school in Mr. Padgett's room, B1312. Just talk to Mr. Padgett if you have any questions.
The Knitting and Crocheting Club would appreciate any donations of extra or unused yarn that anyone may have sitting around at home. It can be dropped off in Senior Academy 210 or with Ms. Harrison in the Team 2022 office.
Hurricanes have caused a lot of damage to the U.S. Let's head over to Gabe Malik to talk about more.
Hey guys, hurricanes have been a common problem in recent years. Here's some information about hurricanes and Hurricane Dorian.
What is a hurricane?
A hurricane is a form of tropical cyclone or a severe tropical storm that occurs in the eastern Pacific Ocean, Caribbean Sea, southern Atlantic Ocean, and the Gulf of Mexico. All coastal areas around the Gulf of Mexico and the Atlantic are prone to hurricanes. Tropical cyclones have low thunderstorm activity and rotate counterclockwise. When the winds of a tropical cyclone are less than 38 miles per hour, it is called a tropical depression. When the winds reach between 39 and 73 miles per hour, it is classified as a tropical storm. However, when the winds exceed 74 miles per hour, it is classified as a hurricane.
What's the deadliest hurricane in American history?
The deadliest storm in American history, the Galveston Hurricane, killed 8,000 to 12,000 people. The then thriving city was all but destroyed when, with little notice, a hurricane made landfall the night of September 8, 1900.
What's the aftermath of Dorian?
As a hurricane, Dorian left the Bahamas devastated, with 60% of homes destroyed in some places and tens of thousands in need of urgent disaster relief. According to officials there, property losses in the Bahamas could hit $7 billion. With sustained winds of 185 miles per hour, Dorian was the strongest hurricane on record to strike the Bahamas since the records began in 1851. The past years have shown that hurricanes are a serious problem in the U.S. Let's hope that everyone stays safe. I'm Gabriel Malik, BHS-TV.
Thanks, Gabe. We hope that everyone can recover from their losses.
Now it's time for sports. Hey, Nathan, what do you have for us today?
Hey, guys. It's been a busy and exciting week for the BHS athletes. Let's start with the volleyball teams who headed the Fishers last night. The varsity came out with lots of intensity and were ready to pounce on the Tigers. After taking the first set 25-21, the Dogs trailed most of the second set, but were able to come back late and took the set 25-23. The Dogs dominated the third set 25-13 and swept the Tigers. Quincy Thomas led the team with 11 kills, followed by Sky Smith with 5. Katie Hardigree had 15 assists and Morgan Sihon had 14. Defensively, Mara Wood had 3 blocks, while Audrey Gordon and Quincy Thomas had 2 each. Maddie Smith had 13 digs. Nice job, ladies. The JV team lost in 2 close sets, but were led by Becca Scott with 8 digs and Katie Floyd and Macy Gibson with 4 kills each. The freshman team took the Tigers to 3 sets, but were unable to get the win. Katie Terrell had 10 kills and Aubrey Pullen had 3 aces. All 3 teams will travel to McCutcheon on Tuesday. The girls golf team wrapped up the regular season on Thursday night at West Chase. The Dogs defeated North Central 163-183 and were led by Kamari Leaf, who shot a 37. Brooke Leanholm followed with a 41, and Kaden Swiljarek had a 42. Victoria Watkins finished with a 43. The ladies will compete in sectionals today. Good luck. And the boys soccer team tied Ben Davis last night 3-3. After falling behind 2-0, the Dogs came back led by Daniel Garcia with 2 goals. Nice job. Good luck to football, cross country, girls soccer, and boys tennis teams who are all in action this weekend. That's it for sports today. Back over to you guys.
Thanks, Nathan. Now let's check in with Johnita for a look at the weekend weather forecast.
Hey guys, it's going to be another warm weekend around Brownsburg. Today the high will be 86 degrees with a low of 66 and mostly sunny all day. Saturday it will be mostly cloudy with a high of 83 and a low of 67. And on Sunday again it will be mostly cloudy with a high of 83 and a 20% chance of stray thunderstorms. Enjoy your weekend. Back over to you guys.
Thanks, Janita. That's all we've got for you today, BHS. Thanks for watching.
Have a great weekend, enjoy homecoming, and be safe. We will see you next week.
Hey, fellas, we ain't gonna ever back down from nobody. I don't care who it is. This is a brotherhood. And if we stand strong together, we can't be denied. If one of us go down, we have another, and another, and another that's ready to fight. So let's hit this field and bang them, bang them, bang them. Somebody, light me up.